Hey guys, Sylvia Perez here. Welcome to today's video. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can go ahead and set up structured snippet extensions. So to get started, just go ahead and hop into your Google Ads campaign, and then in the campaign overview tab, click on the campaign that you want to access, that you want to add these structured snippet extensions for. A shortcut that you can do is just if you go ahead and you press G and then X on your keyboard, it'll jump you right to the extensions tab, so it's a little shortcut for you. But I wanna go ahead and click on the tutorial campaign because I only wanna create ad extensions for this campaign, the structured snippets. So to get started, you're probably gonna see something like this. You can just go ahead and scroll to the bottom, click create ad extension, and if not, then you'll see this page right here, and then you're just gonna go ahead and click on that blue plus sign, and then you're gonna scroll down to structured snippet, and then we'll be able to create these structured snippet extensions. Now, first and foremost, before we get into like actually what to write, let's talk about what structured snippet extensions are. And all structured snippet extensions is a tongue twister. All these extensions do is they highlight different aspects of your service, of your business, right? So let's kind of look at the drop-down menu so we get a better understanding. So if there's different amenities you offer, you can use snippet extensions to highlight those different amenities, different brands, different courses. Maybe you're an education provider, different degree programs if you're a school, destinations, maybe you're a travel provider, featured hotels, insurance coverages, models, neighborhoods, service catalog, shows, styles, types. So the most common one is most likely going to be service catalog, and those would just be different services that you offer within your business. But structured snippet extensions are an amazing extension type to use to really give people more information on when they're searching. So let's go ahead and go with service catalog. And you can see here under values, this is where you're going to go ahead and type in the different services you offer. So I'll just kind of go with the Google example here. So we'll say oil change, and then smog check, and then so on and so forth. And then you can add more extensions. And you can add as many, I think it goes up to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yep, 10. So you can add up to 10 snippet extensions, which should be more than plenty. So that's up to 10 different service offerings that you can showcase in your snippet extensions. Another thing as well is if you go to advanced options, you can also put a preference. So if you only want to show it to mobile devices, you have that ability, as well as maybe you're only going to run the snippet extension for a certain amount of time, maybe because you're only offering a special type of promotion or something, a special type of service offering. You can go ahead and schedule that here with the start date and the end date. You can also add its own ad schedule as well. So you can get very specific on when you're gonna show these service offerings with the snippet extensions. Most of the times, from my experience, I haven't really had to use the ad scheduling for the snippet extension and get very granular. It's usually more at the campaign level I'll do the ad scheduling. But if you're a more seasonal business, if you're running a lot of sales, or if your service offering is changing a lot more frequently, then that might be a feature that you definitely want to take advantage of. Now you can see here in the display feed right here, this gives you an example of what the snippet extension looks like. So you can see it kind of repeats. I want to tell you real quick a little hack you can do if in the case that you do not have enough space to list out all the service offerings that you want to put in your snippet extensions. So you can list up to 10, but let's say 10 isn't enough for you. So a little hack you can do is you can add them together. So for example, let's say I need another space, but I want to also make sure I have oil change and smog check. So what I can do is I can just go here on oil change, type in comma, smog check. And as long as I'm within that 25 character limit, I'll be able to show that. So that's a little hack you can do to be able to add more service offerings into your snippet extension. So you can go ahead and take advantage of that. And you can see how that will be displayed here on the right-hand side. Now, I want to go ahead and show you guys a real life example too of a snippet extension. So if you just go to Google and let's just search structured snippets, just so we can get like a visual of some ads that are running. So you guys can see. So looking at, this is an image from WordStream, so credit to WordStream. This is an example of a structured snippet in the Google Ad service feed. So you can see here services, and then it has these different services right here. So that'll give you an idea of what it will look like on a live ad. Another thing you guys can do as well, if you want to see whether or not your snippet extensions are being shown in the search results page, you can go to Tools and then click on Add Preview and Diagnosis, and then just go ahead and type in one of your keywords, make sure you're in a location that you're targeting, and then you can see whether or not your extensions are being shown for your search results. Also keep in mind that sometimes it varies depending on the result and the query and all the advertisers on whether or not your extensions will be shown, but this is a great way to kind of double check that everything's working properly and it looks all right. And then last but not least, always make sure that when you do create your extensions, that they're actually approved. So once we create an extension, Google's gonna go ahead and put that extension under an approval review, and then just make sure to double check that it did get approved and everything is working smoothly. So that's it for this video, guys. If you have any questions, please do feel free to let me know, and go ahead and follow along and subscribe to the channel if you got some value from this video. I post content every week, and I'll see you next time. Take care.